Hey everybody, NoraZaneta here, and I'm back again with another travel vlog. So if you want to become a glam, you can do that easily by subscribing. On this channel, we discuss how we're building our glam lives through beauty, fashion, faith, and lifestyle. So I am on my way to Houston to cover my first event as a blogger content creator. So this is a new venture for me. I'm very excited. I'm going to take you all behind the scenes of the event, Houston Hosts You, and my first time in Houston. Make sure you subscribe. Stay tuned. Bye. Okay, y'all. I'm officially in Houston. Just landed. I'm about to go pick up my suitcase and check in at the hotel. I'll see y'all at the hotel. All right, y'all. So Vicky was so nice to get me an Uber to the hotel. I stayed at the Embassy Suites Galleria in the Galleria area, a real nice swanky area in Houston. Now, I'm all about the views. I love to see the skyline when I am traveling. I love to see the downtown area, and that's what I'm doing here. And I love to show y'all the views so you know what to expect when you go. It was a beautiful day. Traffic was kind of heavy. I came in on a Thursday and I really just chilled, got to the hotel and had happy hour at the hotel. So I had free drinks, food and free drinks, and then just kind of called it a night. But great flight. I want to shout out Sarah Prophetess for praying for me and my flight, that everything went well, and praying for my trip. It really helped me be calm on the plane because I have flight anxiety. Also, I enjoy flying Southwest. I'm a Southwest girly, and I flew Southwest, so yeah. Hey y'all, Nora. I'm back, and I've made it to the hotel room. I'm gonna go ahead and give you all a room tour on the front end so I don't forget. I've already taken stuff out, but got my carry-on unloaded there because I need to get my charger out. But here is the entry. TV number one. This is a little kitchen area. Make yourself some coffee. Embassy Suites. So many mirrors, they know. They know. Content creator life. Got a fridge down here. Put my little knickknacks in here and microwave. I should have brought me some soup. Here's el baño, the bathroom. And then back into the main suite. I just want to point out, Houston Hosts You. Shout out to the Queen of Yum and the whole team at Houston Hosts You. They had this beautiful welcome set up for me here. Everything black excellence. So we got a little, you know, bonnet, durag bonnet. We got a comb, wide tooth. Then all kind of snacky snacks here. We've got a shirt. I'll unfold that. Probably wear it home. Got me some sweet tea punch. Everything that a Southern gal needs to enjoy Texas, Houston for the first time. And then this cute bag here with my name on it. Look, y'all, that's me. All right, Glam, so it's Friday. We're kicking off Houston Hosts Week End with our content creator meetup, and we're having dinner, or brunch rather, somewhere. I'll show you all when I get there, but here's my outfit. I'm trying to decide what shoes I'm gonna put on, but I put this on because I got on a pad and it's kind of visible, but
Oh, I just got a text. Let me go see what's going on. I'll be back, y'all.
All right, for our first day, we headed down to the lobby. You'll see HEB. It's a Houston, Texas-based retail grocery chain, and they're one of our major sponsors for Houston Host. But all of the influencers met down in the lobby so that we could meet, greet, and hop in our black cars and head over to our first stop. So here is kind of what Houston looks like. I didn't know that Houston has palm trees. So shout out to Shay for letting me know that. But anytime I go on a trip, I love to record the scenery so you can see what you're, you know, so you know what to expect. So here we are heading over to Finn Hall, I believe, so that we can eat brunch at Kraft Burgers.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mustard-based barbecue sauce. If you want to do our barbecue bacon, we make our own bacon in-house. So with the candy bacon, also our Cuban, we smoke for 13 hours. So that's a nice pork with our succulent, our candy bacon, you know, Swiss cheese, pickles, and mustard.
All right. So we had the pleasure of trying many of the popularly ordered items on the menu. Tons of variations of burgers. They even had like a mushroom burger. They was actually delicious. But tons of burgers. We had like waffles and chicken, chicken and waffle, and even a lobster roll. That lobster roll was absolutely divine. And here you are watching us grub and take pictures. But we had some other influencers join from other areas. And we all just sat with each other and stuffed our faces.
Avocado and a mustard-based barbecue sauce.
You gotta have an avocado, baby.
Yo, that is so good.
And Cotto. Come on, Cotto.
Come on, Cotto. Daddy.
Firstly, Houston is so beautiful. I love their transit system. The downtown area is just very scenic. Here we are on our way home, and we actually saw this cute mural. You see so much art. One thing that I really loved about Houston was the art. There's beautiful art everywhere. But we were captivated by this mural section on our way home and stopped and decided to take photos.
It's a black owned spot. He owns the Breakfast Club, Culture, Reggae Hut, and he owns something that we love called Alley Cat, but he closed it. It's Culture is right there.
Oh, he owns that too?
Yeah. Culture with a K.
Yeah, because he's a cat.
It's perfect lighting.
This is the graffiti wall, y'all.
Came in with an athlete on a restaurant.
Is that Slim Thug at the bottom?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, y'all, so we just came back from Kraft Burgers. So good, so good. I am going to take like a 30 minute nap, and then I'm gonna get up and get ready for the evening. And we're wearing all brown for this next event, which is why I did my brown makeup, but I'm gonna touch up and try to be ready by 4:30. All right, bye.
Dallas foodie, the number one guy. Check me out.
Hey, it's your girl Tasha Kwan. I'm the founder of Her Grills, and I'm one of the Houston hosts for this year's Houston Host 2022. Woo woo.
Hey guys, I'm Alexis. I'm a fashion influencer based in Dallas, and I represent right here for Houston Host Week.
Awesome. Oh, this one's cute too. Cheers, guys.
Cheers to you all.
Cheers to Rosé. No, just kidding. Cheers to you guys making it safely. So excited.
So, the first wine you all are tasting is our Tempranillo Rosé. Tempranillo grape is normally used to make a red wine, and we chose to make a beautiful rosé out of this wine, of this grape. This wine is going to give you fruit forward notes of pink grapefruit, strawberry, melon, and a little bit of peach as well. It then transitions to a nice earthiness about it with notes of rose petal, blossom, even some honeysuckle on there on the ends of it. Now, along with our, I know Krista did mention that this is one of our flagship wines, one of the first wines we did start to cultivate when Pinot Noir was found. This wine, along with our Pinot Gris and our Elevation and the Pure Pippin, they want to give fruit forward notes with this wine. So along with their love of wine, they love to travel, and they want to add some of those tropical notes in wine that they love on their travels. So we call this wine a patio wine or a vacation wine, as it's perfect during those times where you want to relax, chill, and just have a good time with the people around you. This wine is going to be the lowest alcohol content that you're going to get out of Pinot Noir, so please be careful, because we want to take y'all, elevate y'all a little bit higher throughout your tasting. So do enjoy the pure euphoria and its beautiful, delicious notes that you're going to be tasting.
All right. Y'all want to pick up y'all glasses? We're going to follow Mr.
Russell. Yeah. I
know. We decided to go with a very deep and rich color palette, you know, for culture. Just thought it was beautiful and quaint. Here, and then we're
going to
transition our rosé into the members' lounge.
Oh,
yeah.
They don't even post.
Yeah. What are you talking about?
You post me.
So we're talking about how easy it is for men to grow their platforms and creator events versus women.
No, I'm not.
I like that. I'll say that.
Nah, it is very
efficient.
I just don't agree.
Yeah, so chill.
What? What are you going to tell me?
I'm telling you.
Rosé me.
Is it clicky?
You're strawberry.
And I know for a fact, people will see you blowing up and they're intrigued by what you do. They will not say the single thing.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just
because
everywhere.
You haven't approached them or been.
So good. Recent. Who's the rosé? The rosé.
Hey, everybody. Okay. We're doing the second part now in our flight. The first is beautiful rosé. Now we're going to go into the red wine category. This is our Sunset Rouge. which is the newest of the collection. We also have 10 wines in our whole collection. Earlier with the rosé wine, I spoke about the rosé being one of the first three. This is the latest of the 10. The Sunset Ruby is the Pinot Noir. Like I said, we are stepping into the red wine territory, so we are going to get a little bit more structure and different.
Pinot Noir, you go boy.
Like
wait,
to tell
how do I focus
about
this?
The five essence. Because red wine, I want to open it up and really get everything about the red wine.
It's good
now. The Sunset Rouge is a blend of Merlot, and it has a very calming vibe in it. So both of those grapes really accent our Pinot Noir and brings out a very nice, subtle complexity. Within this red wine, this Pinot Noir blend, you will get lots of fresh cranberry on the nose. So beautiful, very, very calm, with a nice approach to the tannins. With the tannins, I like to tell people, since it is November, it's a really easier way to eat some turkey. You can do turkey stuffing, you can also do yams, everything for the Thanksgiving food, this Pinot Noir blend.
Talk to the food bloggers.
Once you put it on your palate, you're really gonna get those wild cherries, lots of cranberries, and bitters. So I like to tell people it's like dried roses, and it's nice, beautiful, on your palate and on your nose. Once you get this in the glass, you're gonna see that it's very glossy, very clean, very refreshing. So it makes you want to examine the wine a little bit more, put it on your palate, and enjoy.
Now, a big part of what we do here, thank you, Montreal. Wine education, and the basis of really slowing down and being able to enjoy great wine is what we like to call and refer to as the five S's. So by show of hands, how many of you know the five S's of wine tasting?
Mm-mm, girl.
Okay. Well, we're about to learn you something. All right, so Montrell will guide us through the five S's of wine tasting. You don't know.
So as Marissa was saying, we do like to go over the five S's. I like to tell people, when you go over the five S's, I know sometimes you went out to a restaurant or a wine bar and you see people swirling their wines, kind of looking like, what are they doing? Why don't you just drink it? They're examining the wine. You're basically telling yourself, what are you going to taste before you can put it on your palate? I like to say, it's like you go to work all week, you kind of say to yourself, and on a Saturday night, when you take a shower, you look in the mirror, you kind of open yourself up to step out to the city. That's what you're really doing with the wine with the five S's. Really kind of opening it up and opening your heart. First, what I'd like to have you do is, the first S is to see the wine.
I'm already doing it.
So which one of you want to just tilt it forward in front of you, and then you can look over.
Ooh, we already look professional.
See, because now you're looking at the wine. Now you can see the full hue of the wine. The middle part, the core of the wine is going to be darker than the edge of the wine. You can see the glossy red cherries, ruby note to it, and it's really going to tell you that this should taste very clean. It should taste young and refreshing. So from there, we're going to go with the second S, which would be swirl. That's everyone's favorite part. Let's put our glasses back on the table after we took a nice look at it. And what I like to say is kind of grasp the bottom of the still, kind of put your hands flat on the bottom of the still, and get a nice circular rotation going. You want to catch the wine. You're going to feel it and get tighter and tighter. And tighter and tighter, then the wine is going to really start swirling. There we go. He got up here.
Look at me.
There we go.
You know, look at the wrist.
So what we're doing is we're releasing the aromas of the wine. The wine has been in the bottle this whole time. So we want to release the aromas.
Right.
There we go. Once you release the aromas,
you're not releasing the aromas, G.
Once you're done swirling, let's go to the third S, and that's sniff. Let's put it on our nose and put it right to your nose. Don't be scared of the wine. It's just wine, right? Once you put it on the nose, you get that beautiful cranberry, fresh cranberry, wild cherry, strawberries as well. That's why I really enjoy this part. 80% of what you smell is what you're going to taste as well, so you really just told yourself 80% of what you're about to taste. So the next two S's is everyone's favorite part. Sip and savor. So I like to tell people, just put it on your palate, take a nice sip, and get it all around your cheeks, in front of your gums, and on your tongue, and you're really gonna get those beautiful, light, crisp notes of the cinnamon.
Okay.
Cranberry, those wild cherries, the hibiscus notes, dried roses, very plain with approaching the tannins. And like I said, red wine brings you to a different characteristic, different structure. Those tannins just sits right on top of your lips, lets you kind of, and once you finish, it goes away, brings you ready for more.
And if you do need a cheat sheet,
perfect.
There it is. But let's not forget the five S's on the rest of our lines. It really kind of opens up that experience.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
I love it.
Yeah, it tastes so much different.
Yeah, I was going to say it really did.
Thank you.
Cheers. I need to get with y'all. I got all the setup.
A lot of work. So are you on YouTube?
Mm-hmm. Are you?
I've made like one video.
No, but I was telling them earlier. That's where the money at. I'm not on there either. I'm just telling you.
So I'm doing it this weekend. So
no.
When you vlog.
Oh, you got the live mark. I got one of them.
This is Les from LAG. He's also one of the hosts. You didn't meet him earlier.
What
camera
is it?
A6600.
Oh, okay. 6600. We had a high quality right now.
You're seeing me in 4K. That super HD.
Yeah, they call me in 4K.
Oh, my God. We are silly. This is Alexis. You didn't get to meet her earlier.
How you doing, Alexis?
Good. Nice to meet you.
Experiences. What we do is we bring people into the city and we curate a weekend for you guys. This is the first day of the weekend. Last year it was just food, but Houston is so much more than just food. It's culture. It is Black excellence. It is politics. It's also unity. Houston is a unique city because most of our Black owned businesses, I can go into and possibly see another Black owned owner. And that is something that's unique to this city. Not just this city, because we know you like, Daddy's got that too. Okay. But we really have a unique space here, and it would be remiss of us if we didn't show that to you guys. So, hey, thank you for coming. Have a good time. We're going to turn up. We're going to have a great weekend. If you need anything from this to that, let me know. No, just let me know. Make sure that you're connecting, right, with everyone this weekend. One thing about Houston Host that was super, super beautiful last year is that friendships were made. Friendships that almost were like not friendships were made. And the connection that we have to each other is invaluable. So we want to dismantle any talk about Black people, crabs in a bucket, we don't support. No, this is what this weekend is for, to show us that no, we can collaborate, we can build each other up, and we can do it in Black excellence.
Yeah. Yeah. Good job. She's walking up us. Don't swear. I saw her. Unless she passed us. Okay, there we go.
So this concludes the happy hour at Pure Noir. The wine was great. The charcuterie board from 1818 Charcuterie was awesome as well. I'm going to show you all the end of day one, the painting experience that we had, and day two and three in the next part of this vlog. Stay tuned. Bye.